let's see in the aircraft what happens. In the aircraft, have you seen the design of the wing, how it looks like?
No.
The wing looks something like this. This is the view, like, you know, wing is coming out like that. So if you cut the wing and you look from the front, this is how it will look like. Alright? Now wing has multiple purposes. The design of the wing is such that it generates a force which balances the weight of the aircraft. And also, inside the wing you store the fuel. So you store the fuel. Okay, wing has a huge span area, so rather than having a separate tank to store the fuel of the aircraft, they store it in the wing itself. But that is none of our concern when it comes to studying fluid dynamics here. But still, now if aircraft is moving, how it will move? In this way or it will go like that? That way only, because wing is coming out like this, so aircraft will go like that. Alright, if aircraft is moving like this, how the wind will flow? Wind will flow like this. From the upper side and from the lower side it will flow like this. Yes or no? Any doubt? Now in reality, what is happening? The wind is stationary and the aircraft is moving. Right? So this entire, let us say, wing goes from this position to that position, let us say. And this point number 1 reaches to point number 2 and point number 3 reaches to point number 4. Are you getting what I am trying to say? 1 and 3 are actually fixed in the space. It is a wing that is moving. So wing goes like this. So 1 becomes 2, 3 becomes 4. Understood? This entire wing goes forward. 1 becomes 2 and 3 becomes 4. Alright, now tell me, time taken by 1 to become 2, is it same as time taken by 3 to become 4?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right, it has to be, because this entire wing has, let us say, taken 2 seconds. Guys, focus here. This entire wing has taken, let us say, 2 seconds to go from here to there. So in 2 seconds, 1 becomes 2 and 3 becomes 4. It is not actually the wind is flowing like that. It is that the wing is going from here to there. Oh. Understand that. 1 and 3 are fixed. Are you getting it? But if you see relative to the wing is blowing. Now tell me, whose velocity is more? The upper or lower? Upper one, velocity is more because it has to travel more distance. So pressure will be more where?
Down.
Down. So this pressure, P1 is more than P2. So net force is developed in upward direction. That force is balancing the weight of the aircraft. So force is P1 into area of cross section minus P2 into area of cross section. That is equal to mg. Understood? Any doubt? Is it clear? Copy it down. Now, you might be wondering that just a small shaping the aircraft wing, how it is possible to lift, let us say, millions of kgs of aircraft. So, just to make you believe that it can happen, there is a numerical, there is a very nice numerical in your textbook. I don't know whether you have done that. You have not done it? Okay, let us take that numerical and see what all things should be there. Okay, so you might be wondering that there should be a huge difference between the velocity of upper and the lower wing. Then only such huge aircraft will be, you know, hanging in the air and going flat. Okay, let us see what kind of velocity difference we are talking about. So here is a question, all of you. Okay, what is the time? Okay, so after this numerical, some of you who don't want to take that can leave. we'll be doing we'll be discussing the previous homework and few advanced or KVPY level questions. Okay, here is a numerical. All of you, please get it right. Okay, it is important. The mass of fully loaded Boeing aircraft is this roughly 3.3 into 10 raised to the power 5 kgs. Mass of fully loaded Boeing aircraft. Its total wing area, the total area is 500 meter square. Okay? It is in the level flight with a velocity of 960 kilometer per hour. Okay? You need to find out the pressure difference between the upper and lower portion of the aircraft. Find out. Assuming the aircraft is going in a level flight, right? Let's fly. Flap can change the pressure. Ignore the flap. Density of air, density of air is 1.2 kg per meter cube. You don't need density actually. Anybody got it? What is height? What? Thickness of? I don't know what you're asking. You have to balance the force, right? Balance the forces. Are you applying Bernoulli's theorem? Don't apply Bernoulli's theorem right now. See, forces should be balanced, right? Vertically it is not moving. So net force should be zero. Vertically? Huh? Okay. Done. Why do you need? That is second part. B part. Okay. So, this is suppose aircraft. Alright. From lower side, pressure is P1. The force will be P1 into A. From upper side, force is P2 into A and mg is acting. So vertically the aircraft is not moving, it is moving in the level flight and that too with a constant velocity. So even horizontal direction net force should be zero. So vertically, since net force should be zero, P2A plus mg minus P1A should be equal to zero. So I will get P1 minus P2 as mg by A. This is how much? Anybody got? 6.6 into 10 raised to the power 3 Pascal, which is roughly 0.06 atmosphere. Yes or no? Which is just a fraction of atmospheric pressure. 0.06% of the atmospheric pressure difference should be there from the above plane and the below the plane, and it will lift entire aircraft. Okay, let's see further. There is second part to the question. P1 into lower area of the wing. Okay, you're correct when you say that, but here you need to take the projected area. What I mean is, see, I will be discussing this concept soon. This is kind of the area will be there, right? So pressure force on this will be perpendicular to it. So you need to take component of this force in that direction. When you take so many components, this area will behave as if it is flat. So they have to take component of this area, which is like, if you look from the above, it will look like a flat surface. That is projected area. Okay? But yes, you are correct. So, I could have also told you that ignore that bulge that is coming out. Okay? So, both the ways it is same. Now, this is A part, write down the B part. If you do the B part properly, if you get it, get the answer sitting here, you're done with flow dynamics up to CET level. It's not so easy, right? There's no magic wand that I tell you. If you do this in 2 seconds, your JEE wants to be done. Oh. If there exists such thing, everybody will know it. Okay, here is the B part of the question. Get it right. You need to find the fractional increase in the speed of the air on the upper surface and the between the upper and lower surface. What is the fractional increase in the velocity? What do I mean? Suppose the upper velocity is V1 and the lower one is V2. I am trying to find out V1 minus V2 divided by average velocity, which is V1 plus V2 by 2. Now this average velocity is roughly speed of the aircraft itself. Okay, so basically this is what I want you to find. Alright, now you apply Bernoulli's theorem between a point above and a point below. Height, the width of the wing you take almost zero. Height difference is negligible. Or you need values. Apply Bernoulli's theorem. Height difference is zero. Why pressure? The pressure difference is there, that is what you compress with the first velocity. You confuse me. Anybody? Yeah. V1 plus V2 by 2, you take it as velocity of the aircraft. That is the hint. Done? Now this term, recall P plus half rho V1 square. Recall half rho V1 square is equal to V2 plus half rho V2 square. You are ignoring rho GH because H is same for the
done?
How much?
Find
out how much it is. Take this as 9200 and this should take as 600. No one? 5.9 times from minus? Minus 2. You are close but not very close. By a large margin. As in, if you're asking me what is a percentage, but in terms of absolute value, you're close. No. 6 to 550 को 60 ले गया. No. Okay. No, I'll just write down the equation. I'll not put the values. No calculator. No, no. This all of you have written?
I said it's supposed to be.
Kya supposed to be? Theek hai? Listen here. This is rho times V2 minus V1 plus V2 plus V1 divided by 2 is equal to P1 minus P2. Let's say P1 minus P2 is delta P. Okay. So stop talking. V2 minus V1 is 2 times delta P of 2N. I am taking this as V average. This is my V average, which is the velocity of aircraft itself. Okay, so delta P divided by V average into rho is V2 minus V1. All of you getting this? Now I have to find this divided by V average. So this V average is square. How many of you got till here? Okay, still not getting the answer. 8 into 10 to minus 2. Delta P is how much? 6.5 into 10 is power minus. So 10 is power 3, right? 6.5, 6.6. In the book it is 6.5. Anyways, whatever it is, you get close to that itself. Density is 1.2 and V average is, velocity of the aircraft is 960. So how many meters per second?
800 by 3.
How much is 960 by 18?
160.
800 by 3. Oh, that's a weird value. 800 square divided by 3 square, so it goes in the numerator like this. Okay, so if you simplify this, you're going to get as 0.08. Are you getting it? So in terms of percentage, the upper side should have velocity just 8% more than the lower side's air velocity. That is what this means. V2 minus V1 divided by V is the fractional. Percentage will be this into 100. So the upper wing velocity should be 8% more than the lower wing velocity, and you can lift the entire Boeing aircraft. Okay, so that can be done, right? But if you just look at it as a fact that, oh, such heavy object, how can it be lifted up by just the wing structure? But all you need is very small difference in the velocities. Okay, now somebody asked me, what is the function of the flap? Have you seen the flap in the aircraft wing? So before you take off, they check the flap. And you have to pay attention. If you see the flaps are not moving before you take off, you have to alert everyone. Okay, because that's a process. They have to check the flap. Okay, so what is the function of that? See, what happens is, I'll just roughly explain to you, okay? This may not be the exact explanation. So what happens if you open the flap over here, so the air that is flowing will flow like that. You're increasing the path of the, don't talk, you're increasing the path of the air. So now more velocity is there. So if you open like that, then the pressure difference will be more and you will go up. Are you getting it? But suppose you open it from here, then this path is more now. So you're decreasing the pressure difference. Now it will go down. Are you getting it? Very simple, very crude way I have told you. And on the tail also, there is a flap that moves like this. That will change the direction. If you do it like that, the wind will flow accordingly and you'll get a force in the left side or right side like that. Okay, both the flaps should function. One is to move up and down, other to move is left and right. Okay. Alright, so that is all the theory for this class. We are done with the fluid dynamics. Next class, we will complete the chapter. Okay? And please. saw a lot of questions from this chapter. If you have not done for the fluid statics, make sure you do it. It is okay that you are only getting 30-40% of the assignment. Assignment number 1, as you have heard, most of the people found it difficult, but 2 and 3 were very straightforward. So if you get scared from assignment 1 itself, you will never open 2 and 3. Okay? So even if you are getting 40%, 30%, but you are doing it yourself, that is sufficient. Okay?